easily trigger that memory. It's not so much the professional shows when they anticipate it, but again, it's those illegal backyard shows. In Illinois, Class B1.3 and Class C1.4G, they're also known as consumer fireworks explosives. They're illegal for sale by the general public. Violations can result in fines up to $2,500 and a year in prison. Professional pyrotech operators are regulated by both the state and the federal government, and we encourage you to go to those shows. Next, we're going to do our demonstration to show how quickly a well-intentioned backyard fireworks display can turn horrific and even fatal. I'm going to have Wally Schroeder, Chief Schroeder with the Chicago Fire Department, come up and make it happen. Wally.
So it might be a little bit more difficult.
Well, we'll get the mic.
So it's a bit windy today, so we may have some difficulty. But it doesn't deter the dangers of this happening. As you heard from all of the guest speakers here, fireworks are extremely dangerous. And as we know, we're in a bit of a drought right now. So if your grass is like mine, it looks like hay. Any little spark right now could potentially cause a conflagration. That's where we have to be safe with this. Let the professionals do it. Even had difficulty getting our sparkler lit. Now please keep in mind, sparklers burn at over 1,000 degrees. Imagine if you had someone that their clothes caught on fire, their first inclination is to start to run, especially a small child, which is going to spread the flame, as you see, going up the shirt. On a windy day like this with 20, 25 mile an hour gusts, you can imagine how it's going to spread.
As you can see, it doesn't take much for a little tiny innocent sparkler, which people put on birthday cakes and hand to toddlers, can do horrific burns and very, very quickly. Does anyone have any questions for any of the speakers or the Chicago Fire Department?
I'm sorry, Roseanne, could you please repeat that? Yes.
Desperate need of rain, and so some people are wondering, is that going to have an impact this year on fireworks?
Certainly. And you know what? That's why it's even more critical. The question was about the drought, and is it play a significant impact on fireworks displays? Absolutely. Even more caution is taken with these, especially with the professionals that are out there. Remember, they're licensed to do this. So they're collaborating with the local fire departments, if you look at these professional displays. And that's where the importance of safety comes into play. That's why you should be watching them as with a professional and not at home. It's extremely dangerous now. You see what it did to the shirt and how it burned it. Could you imagine skin or a child? And that was a simple sparkler. We think that's, you know, you give it to the kid, he's running around with it. unfortunately, this is the aftermath. Now let's add another problem to it, which is the drought. Now your child learned to stop, drop, and roll, right? We've learned that in school. They cover their face, they go to the ground, and they start rolling around in this drought-ridden lawns. Could you imagine them what could potentially happen? So please protect them, protect yourself. Fireworks are nothing that we should be using. That's strictly by a professional, please. Did that answer what you were looking for?
Also, another problem with the amateur fireworks is the majority of fireworks coming into this country that are used by amateurs are manufactured in China. And at the Border Patrol, when they do their sting operations, what they're finding is that the majority of them don't meet the Consumer Product Safety Commission standards. The wick is too short, they're more potent than they're packaged. So that's part of the problem too. A lot of them are malfunctioning, and when they don't go off, then people are looking over them and they're exploding. And so you're really dealing with faulty products too that really aren't regulated by, you know, the United States government. And again, another reason just to go to the professional show. Does anyone have any questions for Aileen, or otherwise she's available afterwards for interviews? Okay, thanks for coming out. We appreciate it. We know parking was a pain, so we appreciate you coming out.
Listen, oh wow, my camera is not updated. I'm not going to lie. I was expecting a lot more out of that demonstration, and that was like the whole reason that I did this thing was a CFD demonstration on the danger of fireworks, and that was a bit of a bust. I did the same kind of live stream with the tree that, you know, Christmas time, dry tree CFD demonstration, and they had to try like multiple times, and the turkey. That's 3 for 3 that demo has not been what I expected. The point of all of this, I guess really, honestly, it wasn't to see fire, which the internet side of me was like, oh, let me get that up. It was to talk about the inherent dangers of fireworks and sparklers. In fact, they used a sparkler to light that shirt on fire or attempt to, and then a little bit of water. But the question asked at the end there, that's probably the most important element of all of this, is just that it is so dry outside that we are in this ongoing drought situation. And yeah, they demonstrated how quickly a shirt could catch on fire in a windy day. but even more importantly is how quickly any of your dry... Okay, I'm going to bring this comment in because it's too good, from Instagram. Bridge fail, tree fail, fireworks fail. I didn't fail that one, but it definitely relates to everything that you just listed there. So that's funny. Anyways, just the dryness outside. Any plants, certainly grass can catch on fire. And if you have enough of it and it's all that brown stuff, there's definitely some dangers this year when it comes to fireworks. And even sparklers, there has a danger. Certainly some of the bigger fireworks, the ones that are technically illegal in the state of Illinois, have quite a bit of danger. And so their whole point here was just don't do it. Be safe. Go to the professional displays there. I've summarized the entire intent of this press conference for you. And yeah, I definitely expected a lot more fireworks. Ha, fireworks. Fire in their demonstration. As I think Sunderman.John did as well. There you go. Be safe out there. Hey, I've got more live streams planned for the day. In about 10 minutes, the Chicago Public Schools is kicking off their summer meals program. We're going to talk about the details of that program, and then I don't have my list with me. I believe it's around noon. Yep, noon. There is a grant announcement involving Google, and then Mayor Brandon Johnson will be there. So Google is giving out the grants. It's not that the city of Chicago is giving Google a grant. And then a little bit later today, I'm planning, it just depends on the timing, but President Biden is supposed to speak about the managing the risks of artificial intelligence. And for those that haven't heard the breaking news, just this morning, his son Hunter Biden pleading guilty to 3 federal charges. So this will be the first time that we potentially hear from the president after that news breaking. So we may actually hear a bit from him on that, certainly if he takes questions. More than likely, that'll be the first question asked, even though his planned event is about artificial intelligence. So lots of live streaming today on WGN News Now. I hope you guys join me for a few of them. Until that next live stream, I'm Chip Brewster. Have a good rest of your day. Be safe out there.